There is a sense of pride of being New Yorkers, whether you were born or bred or became a New Yorker.
I had many highlights for the past 4 years. I learned a lot of life lessons here. I think this is very typical as a CCNY student in such diverse campus.
I was so honored and happily surprised when I found out that I'm the valedictorian of the class of 2019. I'm very humbled by the experience because I know so many people who are a lot more hardworking, who are a lot more naturally intelligent than I am, who have had to overcome so many more obstacles than I've been faced with during my time here at CCNY. And so I just hope that I do it justice.
First of all, I feel really honored. I came here when I was 15, so as a first generation immigrant, from the point that I barely spoke English to now receive this honor, I'm very happy that I didn't waste my family's efforts. I didn't let my parents down. I'm currently doing research on a microfluid field. So microfluid is the manipulation of the fluid flow in a very small channel. Like the channel size is from 1 to 1,000 micrometers. We can generate monodispersed emulsion drops in this channel, which means we can generate the drops with same size and multiple liquid layers. We can even make medicines with this technology so that control how the medicine capsule break in a specific location within the body. This technique is very good. But the device that can be used for this technology is not that easy to be fabricated. So our project is to develop a new device that can be conveniently fabricated.
My research is involved in the area of public health. As an aspiring doctor, I'm not only concerned about individual health, but also the health of communities. So this last summer, I had the amazing opportunity to go to Tanzania for 6 weeks. And in Tanzania, cervical cancer is a large issue. It's a cancer that is mostly preventable because it is caused by an infection. However, in Tanzania, a lot of women are not aware about cervical cancer. They don't know that they should be going to their doctor regularly, or they may not have the means to do so. So there are unfortunately very high rates of death due to cervical cancer in Tanzania. So the research that I did this summer was I went there and I interviewed 200 women about what barriers were standing in their way of completing referral or making it to their appointments so that we can better understand how we can serve women in the community.